Hello guys and welcome back to a new video. Today I'm right here at Toyota and I have a very interesting car. It's a brand new car that come today right here and it's the new Toyota Corolla Tourer GR Sport. And today I will make a full review for you guys. I try to go in the interior, exterior. I try to show you as many details as possible. And for short, I want to tell you a few words that the car, it's really beautiful. I love the exterior design. I like the technology. And also, it has a lot of space in the trunk, much bigger space than the small brother hatchback, the Corolla hatchback. And let's do it. We have the new rims and a few new things on the car. Let's do it. Let's make this this review, guys, and I hope you enjoy it. If you didn't subscribe to my channel, just subscribe right now. If you want to see the newest car on the market, just subscribe and check it out on my channel. Also, we have on the key this button. So when you press this button, usually the car have this automatic lift gate on the trunk, and also when you push it back, it should close. So just press it up and then the car will close the trunk, guys. So anyway, first time, let me start with the exterior of the car, and I will try to go a little bit around the car, guys, to show you every single detail. As I told you before, the car come with these new rims right here. So we have 18-inch rims and they look super beautiful. Also ventilated brake discs right there. We have black with this chrome design combination. In my opinion, they look very nice and they fit super nice with the car. They fit perfectly. They did a great job with the design, that's for sure. I really like the design, and I like this combination of white with black on the roof. So the car, it's white, it's a beautiful white. It's kind of, I will tell you a little bit later the color inside. It's not kind of white, it's kind of white gray like that, but it's very beautiful. By the way, guys, if you are from Switzerland, you can come at Emil Frey right here in Bern. They have amazing cars, and you can test drive it here, you can see it, and also you can see the cars right here. Anyway, we have 2-liter engine hybrid right here on the car, and I will show you a little bit later the information of the car. But first time, let me go around the car to show you a little bit the car, the way it looks, the front design, the full LED light. The car come with the full LED lights, the newest technology from Toyota. Also 6 parking sensors in the front as well as in the back. Beautiful design here. We have also LED light on the fog lamps, and pretty nice. I like that the grille is really big. You can see also on the number plate, Corolla GR Sport. Behind this logo here, we have the radar for adaptive cruise control, emergency brake, and all that cool future safety feature these days. Also, what can I say? I like very much the design. There, in the middle of the windscreen, we have the camera for reading the traffic signs, the traffic speed limit, and also help for the lane assist. Pretty good. I think I show you everything around here. You can see also the shape in the front. It's very similar with the hatchback version. I like a lot this down here, this part down here. They add this plastic right here with some glossy black there. It looks also very nice. The mirrors look also great, as you can see here. I will show you a little bit later. We have right here the blind spot technology right here on the mirror. They are big and you have a great visibility. Also keyless entrance in the car. You just have to press here, put your finger there, and the car, it's locked. When you want to unlock it, you just open the door and then the car, it's unlocked. So pretty awesome. Also the quality on the doors is great. You can hear when the door is closed. It's a nice sound. Also here on the left side we have this tank, but I think you have to open it from the interior of the car. if I'm not wrong, around here. Let me see where you are. It's not here, I don't know where is this button to open the trunk. Here are the lights. Usually it should be here, the trunk and the gas. Yeah, pretty strange. I don't know where is the button to open that. Why I don't know that anyway. Anyway, guys, let me go in the back. I like the windows this time, they are so big and you have such a great visibility. We will go inside and I will show you. Also around the windows we have some black matte rubber here around the windows. It looks also nice. Also on the roof, guys, you can add some extra luggage there, an extra trunk up there on the roof, all black. And also the spoiler here in the back, it's all black, and it's looking very nice on the car. We have the brake lights, LED lights there as well. Pretty nice design here in the back as well. We have 6 parking sensors on the car as well as in the front. Right here you can see the parking sensors. And also I like very much this design of the bumper in the back, those sharp edges, sharp lines. Also some light reflector right here for the cars that come from the back. It is very useful in the night, those light reflectors. I like the exhaust pipes right here in the right side, and also this glossy plastic down there. The air diffuser look beautiful, really nice. The car look fantastic on the exterior. I like it very much, the exterior design. Also you can see the GR hybrid logo here on the side. We have the Corolla on the other side, and also a lot of sharp edges, sharp lines here and there, that they look fantastic even up here. I like it very much the way they designed the car, the Toyota logo. We have the camera here in the back, and also LED lights on the number plate. So pretty awesome. I don't know about you guys, but I like the car very much. I like the lines. If you look from here, from the side design, the lines of the car are phenomenal. They look super nice. Really nice design. Yeah, you can see it also from the side here. And from the front again, guys, you can see the bumper down there. It's quite interesting. It's like a big mouth. The grille is looking like a big mouth. And also I like the glossy plastic down there. It looks super nice. Let me open up a little bit the lights for you, the blinkers, guys. And then also the light from here. I just want to show you the LED lights in the back. They look super nice, guys. Look at this. So they look very good. I like the way the design come there. Also the blinkers, you can see it there in the images to make an idea about this. Yeah, not bad. Let me go here. Also here, we have just a little bit LED light on the mirror right there. The mirrors are in black. They look very nice as well. Then here in the front, we have this daylight LED. I think you can see it flickering. And then the blinkers right there in the middle. They also look very nice. I like the way they look. Yeah. Anyway, let me go, let me close this. Also the handle on the doors, look how cool is the handle, how cool is to open it up. And let me close that, guys. And I want to give you a few information about the car, the price and all that stuff. So we have here the Toyota Corolla Touring Sports. And then you see, this is the basis model. But this right here with me is not this one. But the starting price for the engine with 1.2 liter turbo with 4-cylinder, 160 horsepower, it's at around 27,002 francs. And this model right here that is with me, the Corolla GR Sport Tourer, it's 2-liter engine, hybrid, 184 horsepower, 4-cylinder, and also all these options that you see right here are on the car. And the price of this car, it is with the discount, because you have some discounts here. If you come at Emil Frey, you have the price 39,000 francs. 39,000 francs for this car. Also here you can see the information. The car is a hybrid milled, so it doesn't have an extra engine here. I will show you in the moment. Also, it's in the A class. That's something that I like. So let me open the frunk and let me show you the engine. I'm sure most of you are interested in seeing the engine. Let me see, I don't remember where was that opener. Let me go down there, I don't remember. How you? I think here, yeah? Or not here. Where are you? Where are you, man? Where is this? I really don't remember where is this stick right here to open up. I think I did it once, but I actually don't remember. Where is this one? It's right here in the middle. Yes, I find it out. So actually this one right here, it is manually, so you have to put something there. But anyway, let me show you the engine, guys, here. So here is the engine. Yeah, for most of you, nothing interesting, just this big battery here that you can see, it's right here in the middle. Also there is the fuse box, we have the air filter here, and there in the left side we have the coolant for the brakes and all that stuff. But anyway, for most of you, not so important, but I just show you, maybe you're curious how those engines look like. So right now, guys, let me go in the back. As you see, we have automatic lift gate in the trunk, right here. The quality feel very well and it's looking very nice. Here are the buttons up here. Other than that, we have just plastic. We have a handle to close it manually. We have this part here, protection for the trunk that stay fixed up there. And we have a huge trunk, a very, very long trunk, guys, here. A lot of space in the trunk. I have to tell you, I'm really impressed. It's much more space in this Corolla Tourer than in the normal Corolla. Also, we have some aluminium here, good quality. Also plenty of space right here in the left side. In the right side, we have a 12-volt port here, guys. We have the handles to fold down the seats. I think you already see it before, I will show you later. Also, this protection for the trunk, you can pull it like that, pull it up. Of course, you can take it out if you want to carry bigger items. And also, I like the fact that it's all flat here, so we have a flat floor here at the entrance in the car. So pretty, pretty cool. Here under the floor here, guys, it is another huge, huge space where you can put a spare tire or wherever you want to put it. It is a very deep space and huge. I don't know how can I show you that. You can see my hand, it's almost half of my hand down there. It's quite interesting. And the cool fact is that you can put this also under there. So if you want to put it under, let me put this camera a little bit up there. So you can take this out and you can put it under. So you still have, you can win much more space here in the trunk. And you can see you have like 10 centimeters here. Pretty awesome that you can adjust this part down here, this floor. You can adjust it the way you want it. And also down there, you still have a space where you can put your stuff. It's really hard because this is very long. It is a very long trunk. We have hooks there, aluminium hooks. Great quality. Great job, Toyota. I think you did a great job with this. With this car, in my opinion, it's pretty awesome. Let me show you how easy it is to fold down the seats. You just have to pull this up. Bam, the seats are down. Just like that, guys. Look at this. Really, really awesome. And look look at these guys, everything is flat there. You have a flat floor, a huge, huge space here. You can carry mobile parts, fridges and stuff like that. Really nice, I like that. Great job, Toyota, I'm really impressed with it. And now guys, you have a beautiful car, exterior car. It's really beautiful and it's very practical as well. So it looks super sporty and I like it very much. Also with the tinted windows in the back, it looks phenomenal. You have a big entrance here in the car. I like the entrance very much. Also, you can see there inside the car. Here, I wish it was LED light. They are only bulb lights. I wish it was LED. But other than that, look at this. Huge space, flat floor, amazing space here in the interior, guys. And also you still have plenty of space on the legs. Down there you have a little step, not like in other cars. For example, in Audi, where you have a bigger step there. In this one, you have a almost flat one, and it's cool to have so much space there, even on the legs. So really impressive. I like that. Here we have some plastic here on the side, but if we fold back the seats, guys, you can see that you have this side support leather here, so you don't have to worry too much about that. Now, let me close the trunk, guys. Press the button. And then we will go inside to show you the space in the interior. So let me go here, guys. Let me fold back the seat. It's very simple to fold it back. Just put it in and it's ready. Here in the middle, we have a center armrest, two cup holders, leather, very good quality. I like that very much, to be honest. I really like it. Also, you cannot open up only the middle part, so like for example carry skis and stuff like that, you have to pull it all the way down the seats, but that's not a big problem. So let me go on the other side, close the door, so just like that. And I want to show you also the doors are made, the windows here in the back are made from two parts, because in this way you can fold down the window all the way down. This window will stay fixed, but this one you can fold it all the way down. Here in the back, the quality, it's good. So it's soft material. All over here is soft material. So not like in the GR hatchback, in the Corolla hatchback. Here you have soft material in the back as well. You can see also the stitches right here, the red stitches look fantastic. The handle nice, soft material down here on the armrest. Also you can see the stitches here, the button look nice, a little bit of chrome there, the handle, some storage space here, not so big storage space, kind of small, but you have the speaker down there as well. So first time, before I go inside the back, I want to go in the front and I want to adjust this seat. Wow, today it's a little bit cold outside. It's a nice day but cold. Just let me adjust it in my position. Yes, just like that. This is kind of my driving position, but I put it a little bit in the back for the tall people, so that the tall people know how much space you have in the back as well. So now let me go inside, guys, right here. And behind the front seat, it's leather all over. It's leather storage here. Here we have two vents. They feel nice. But I wish it was some USB ports down there. It's not, unfortunately. But yeah, I guess I can live without that. I like this here, this step. It's almost invisible, so you can go in the middle very easily. Oh, let me close the door. And you can immediately see that here it's a lot of traffic, a lot of cars driving around here, trucks and stuff. And you can see how silent it is inside the car. So the isolation is pretty good, not bad. Here you have a handle, a hook. The roof quality is not the best, I can say medium, stuff like that. But look at the space, guys. Look how much space I have on my legs. Huge space on my legs. You can see in the front the position of the seat. This is my driving position. And this is kind of much more in the back. I don't know who stay like that, but anyway. Huge space on my legs. I can stretch my legs a little bit in the front there. Also on my head, plenty of space on my head. Great job, Toyota. I like that. The visibility, I don't even need to tell you guys. fantastic visibility. Also, because of this window here in the back, you have a great visibility. Headroom, plenty headroom, pretty good job. Also, they are very comfortable, those seats. Let me go in the middle. I go very easy because of the invisible step there. Kind of four fingers here. Stretch my arms, almost stretch my arms, almost there. Three people here, no problem, even for long trips. So, wow, good job, good job. Also on the head, you see it on my knees. You can see here, this is my driving position, and this is the other one that it's way, way too much in the back. So I can stay with my legs together just like that. Something that you cannot do in other cars in this class, to be honest. Leather here, great quality. Armrest, then you can see the center console. It's kind of simple. They can make it a little bit more complicated, but you have everything you need right there. Anyway, the dashboard, it's nice, a lot of great quality there. It's leather with stitches, nice design. I like the design, I like the steering wheel, and you can see for yourself also the speakers on the dash, the multimedia system, everything. It's gorgeous. Let me go in the front. Actually, as a passenger in the back, I never liked those sport seats because you don't have such a good visibility there in the front. Anyway, you look on the window, so this is my crazy ideas. But anyway, let me go in the front to show you the rest of the car. I like also the doors, the way they close, they sound so nice. Look at this door, look at this door, how big it is. Look at the windows, how big it is. It's a huge windows, that's why they have to make two parts, because it's a really big window and you have a good visibility, I have to tell you, because I know. Also here, soft material all over the upper part, you can see the stitches. Then you have also here soft material, the same as in the back. And then you have the handle, chrome, you have those buttons, electric windows, electric adjustable mirrors right here. Pretty cool. Much more space here as in the back. And also we have this glossy plastic right here with some chrome design that look pretty nice. The GR logo, GR, right here with some aluminium, look very nice. At the entrance in the car, immediately you feel like you are in a special car right here, in a sport one. Manual adjustable seats, guys, you can see it from here. You see it before, I just adjust it. But the seats, they look gorgeous, gorgeous. Look at them, look at them. We have this GR special seat. We look at the stitches, look at this insertion aluminium, or it's plastic here, but it looked like a chrome design. Then we have leather with red stitches, nice white fabric material. Also here, all the middle part is fabric material. But you know what, guys, I find out something. I have a lot of experience with the cars, and I find out that these fabric materials are very comfortable, to be honest. I find some of them very comfortable even for long trips. Anyway, here we have all that buttons for the lights, for example, for the fog lamps. This is for opening the trunk, traction control, heated steering wheel, and the parking sensors. I want to go inside because it's kind of cold outside. All right, and it's much more, the noise is not so big inside the car. I like also that speaker there, look how nice they do it. Nice, interesting design with glossy plastic, and another speaker around there. Then we have the van, the head-up display right there. Guys, the car comes with the head-up display, another speakers on the other side, and all this dashboard, it's soft material, very soft, very good quality here. You can see you have the stitches. Also here, soft material everywhere, it's soft material. I like that. Even down here is soft material, stitches everywhere on the dash, very good quality. To down here to the start stop engine button. Down here we have plenty of space, a lot of space in the glove box. Really, to be honest, it's quite big. Then going down a little bit, here we have heated seat, guys. You can heat your seats with these buttons. And also here come the charging for your phone, wireless charging. That's another cool stuff. I like the way they combine the doors with the dashboard. Pretty awesome. Also the vents, not bad. They feel quite good as you touch it. Not bad at all. Big windows, great visibility around the windows. You can see for yourself right now that you have a lot of good visibility around the car. What I told you in the back there, they make that window. But I find out that those are the best car. The cars in this class, look, whoa, how big is this mirror? Whoa, oh my God, it's really big, this mirror. Impressive, you can see your kids in the back as well, not only the window, it's quite a big window, big mirror here, and I like it, I like that. Also here you can see the mirror, and also normal bulb light. I wish it was only LED lights inside the car. Why they put those bulb lights? Too bad about that, but I don't care too much. Here it's SOS button, guys. Yeah, what can I told you? This is the armrest, you can adjust it, back, front, open up, you have there an USB port and 12 volt port, very useful, I like that. And a big space here where you can put your stuff, glossy plastic, I like the glossy plastic, two cup holders, electric handbrake, auto hold, perfect, all I need in the car, and also here is the stick for changing the gear automatically. Here we have the driving mode, AV. You can change the driving modes from this stick here. You can go in AV mode and stuff like that. Here is the button for AV mode. Here you go in sport, comfort, eco, stuff like that. Anyway, very nice. Other than that, here's plastic around here if you're wondering what is that. Let me go a little bit in the back. Here, guys, going up a little bit, here we have the climatic system. Let me press the button. Here we have the climatic system, I will show you in a moment. We have some vents here integrated between the multimedia system and the climatic system. The blinkers button, I don't need music right now, please. Not now, all right. Then, I like the glossy plastic insertion with the chrome design, a little bit on the dash there. The steering wheel, it's gorgeous. I like the steering wheel very much. You can see the stitches here. You can see how good it's made with red stitches. The buttons right here to adjust different function on the cockpit, for example. And also here on the other side, we have the cruise control, lane assist, adaptive cruise control. This is this automatic emergency brake and all that stuff. Change the different modes from here, I'll show you in a moment. But the steering wheel, it's quite nice. It's really good quality. All right, guys. The seats are also comfortable, and I like the fact that they have this side support. They are sporty seats, and they feel good being inside here. Let me go a little bit through this multimedia system. Already make a review with it. If you want to see the full review with this multimedia system, check out on my channel. This is the home screen. Here you have the navigation, and you can customize the way you want it for the multimedia system. Telephone connection. Here you go to menu. Menu is the most important, because in the menu you find everything, every application and everything you need, you find it here. So if you go to application, here you can connect your car to the phone, and you can connect, here you have this in-car A-store, you can connect on the internet to take all that stuff. You can activate this smart device link, and then you can connect your phone to the car, to the multimedia system, and then you have the Google map and all that stuff right here on the screen, but I don't want to go into detail. Then you have the here you have the navigation, you can choose different stuff. Then you have the audio, telephone, I'm not going to go in detail as well. Then you have here the settings. Those are the most important. Here you can change even the language if you want. Right now it's in English. You can customize the home screen from here. You can change the voice, recognize, preference, service, Toyota online, beep, anyway, tema, and stuff like that. Fusion, units measure, you can change this how you want to see it, blah blah blah. Anyway, then you go to Bluetooth. Can connect to Bluetooth, audio, phone, voice. Then you have navigation, Wi-Fi, smart device link, online,
and stuff like that. I don't want to go too much into detail, just want to show you briefly like that. And then going forward, here you have all the information about the car, trip information, energy flow, history, blah blah blah. Anyway, go back to menu, and yeah, I guess display information right here. The camera, for example, in the back, you can customize in colors and stuff like this. And then, yeah, then you have the audio, you have shortcut button also here. For example, you go directly to the map, you just press this button, and here on the side, setup and phone also from here. It's very simple to use. We have the GBL sound system inside this car, and it's gorgeous. It's gorgeous sound. The navigation, guys, you can see it has no lag at all. To be honest, it's worked just fine. It's perfect. It's not Mercedes or Audi, but it is perfect. You have the tank, gas station, and all that stuff around there. So pretty nice. I like that. I like that very much. Now, let me show you this climatic system right here. You can see you have a screen, kind of a digital screen, where you can adjust the different section, fast, eco, you have all that stuff, dual climatic system, blah blah blah, turn it off. Good. Now, one of the cool stuff on this car is the new digital display right there on the screen, something that I like it very very much, to be honest, guys. Now here you can customize all that stuff. On the screen you can see all the information are there. Those on the side here are standard classic, where you see the thermometer, and also on the side the gas tank, and the how much temperature you still have on the car. And yeah, what can I say, you can customize from here. You go here, but tell me, I have to start the engine first time. The key is right here with me. I just put the contact and I start it, and you can see right there in the middle you have all kind of information, guys. Also on the screen there on the left side up, you have the how much speed you can drive, you can read the speed limit, you can customize the middle part. You can see here the lane assist, all that safety system, blind spot, the parking sensors, and head-up display. Oh yes, I don't know if you can see the head-up display, guys. I almost forget about it. But why the head-up display? Wait a second. The problem with the head-up display is that you cannot see it. The brightness is not so good, but it's great. It looks super, super nice. Let me try to close a little bit the brightness to see if you are able to see it. Maybe you are. You can see it right now? Yes. You can see it. I think it is an option somewhere around here to make it brighter. I think you can see it there in the middle. Yeah, you can see it. Anyway, it looked nice. It's perfect on the windscreen. It's the same as on the BMW, for example, or Mercedes. So you have a great, great visibility. You have the speed limit, you have the traffic, the speed and all that stuff. Pretty awesome. Anyway, here you can, the car can read all that stuff. Those are the safety settings right here. Pretty awesome. Let me go left. You have here all the information about the distance, how much you drive, and the battery, how much battery is still in the car, because it's a mild hybrid, so you have a battery that helps the engine to consume less. This car have great consumption, guys, really good consumption, around 3 point, to be honest, around 3.54 there. Here you can see the consumption, but the consumption, it was big because the engine was really cold and they drive just a little bit. The car has only 98 kilometer, but if you drive normal, the consumption is awesome. Anyway, you can customize the car in different ways, just like that. You have all the information there. The screen, it's pretty, pretty awesome. Also, you have all that buttons for the lane assist. You can see it appear on the screen every time you touch those buttons. Right now, we are in the EV mode. So actually, to be honest, guys, right now the engine it start, but you hear nothing because the start, the car is starting heavy mode. Here is the camera. You have a back camera around the car, also 6 parking sensors in the front, in the back. Great visibility from the driver point of view. I will make a test drive with this car as well, guys. If you want to see a test drive, just please let me know. Also, from this button, driving mode, you can change the driving mode, normal, comfort, eco, and then you have sports mode, you have sport plus S, and you have custom, but we will leave it in eco. And then you have the EV mode button right here. So if I press this button, guys, let me just like that, let me try to EV mode. All right, pretty awesome. The engine right now, guys, to be honest, right now we close it. If you press one more time, just like that, you can see that beautiful Corolla logo come on the screen, and also here it say Toyota and all that stuff. So it is pretty awesome. Anyway, guys, I think you make an idea about the car. I hope you really enjoyed this review, guys. I hope it was helpful for you. I like the car very much. If the car has this electric seat, was better, and also I wish it was LED light inside the car. But other than that, beautiful design, a lot of space inside, a lot of great quality, even on the door, soft material almost everywhere. The price, it's great. You see it before. You know, Toyota make fantastic cars, and the engine, this engine, it's gorgeous. You know, Toyota have fantastic hybrid engines that they are lasting very long time. I'm not trying to make an advertising, but this is the truth. You know, everybody know that Prius was one of the best car out there, with many years and many thousands of kilometers. You know, the taxi drivers all over the world have the Toyota Prius because the consumption, because of the engine was so reliable, and you don't have to go all the time in service with it. But anyway, guys, I really hope you enjoy the review. Please subscribe to my channel if you want to see more of those videos. I have plenty of other review, check out on my channel. Also, check out the other Corolla GR Sport hatchback if you want to see it. Oh, I have it on my channel. The next will come a test drive with the Toyota Corolla, this GR hatchback, or maybe tourer, I don't know. Maybe with hatchback I will make a test drive. But stay with eyes on my channel if you want to see it. Comment down below, tell me what you think about that. I want to hear your feedbacks, and thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe, guys, it will mean a lot for me. And thank you very much for watching again. See you soon. Stay safe, drive safe. Bye, guys.